everybody. Gotta get your praise on tonight.
Blessed assurance. Oh, what for days, glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, and washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song. I'm praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. I'm praising my Savior all the day long.
Yes, Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We're going to have our mistress of ceremony come, Minister Alberty.
As the word of God is on today, I am Evangelist Alberty, and I'll be your mistress of ceremony for this afternoon. This is the day the Lord has made us rejoice and glad in it.
Amen.
And every day you wake up, it's a blessing to be alive. It's Amen. A blessing if you're saved to be a part of the kingdom of God.
Amen.
And we come here on this afternoon for the ordination service for Apostle James Taylor. That's a blessing.
Amen.
And someone received their calling. God calls each one of us. Once somebody realizes that God has called me to do this, I'm going to step out and walk out in faith and be who he has purposed me to be. It's a blessing. So I open this up prayer. It's by Prophetess Andrea McGee. Is she here?
Amen.
Praise God.
If we could just stand in reverence, God. Bow your heads, please. Father God, we just thank you for allowing us to be here on this night, Father God. Not just for ordination service, Father God, but just to invite you in, Lord God. To invite your Holy Spirit in, Lord God, to take charge of this service, Father God. Father God, not just for him to be licensed and ordinated in, but just for the people of God's hearts to be changed, Lord God. Father God, to stir up everything inside of them, Father God, that they may run after you even more, O God. You said the deep calleth unto the deep, O God. Let us call unto you on tonight, O God. Father God, let us worship you in spirit and in truth, O God. Let us worship you, Father God, because you are Elohim, Father God. You are Jehovah Jireh, Lord God. You are Jehovah Nissi, Lord God. Father God, you are everything that we need, Father God. For you said you are Yahshua, Father God. And we trust you, Father God. For you are everything to us, Lord God, on tonight, oh God. Father God, equip us, Father God. Equip us for the journey, Father God, that you put us on, Father God. Equip us, Father God, to be lovers of your heart, Father God, to one another, Father God. Let your loving kindness dwell in us, O God. And let this service, Father God, be blessed in your holy name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
Okay, we prepare for our scripture reading. It's Minister Darrial Love. It's going to be the Old Testament and the New Testament, too.
God, we'll be reading from Psalms 91, starting at verse 14. Psalms 91, starting at verse 14. And it reads, because he has set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. And the New Testament scripture I'm going to be reading. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, starting in verse number 9. Second Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9. And it reads, and he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. May the Lord bless the hearers and doers of his word.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
You may be seated. Now for the cage, we'll have Minister Douglas Moore.
Amen. Amen. I'd like to thank everyone for coming out. This is a special occasion, the ordination service for my brother, James Taylor. Not only is he my brother in Christ, but he's my blood brother. So I just want to thank everyone for coming out for this special occasion, and I hope everyone that will be blessed during the service. And once again, just like to thank everyone for coming out.
Amen. Amen. Now, we have a response from guest ministries. Anyone respond, like to respond tonight? Let us know.
I'll say something.
Praise God.
From his church, House of Prayer, we just thank you for your warm welcome. We're looking forward to meeting you. Thank you.
Amen. Praise God. Anyone else? We thank God for that. The praise and worship, Prophetess Felicia Rhodes.
Amen.
And then following her will be the offering.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I will bless the Lord. Hallelujah. At all times. Yeah. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth, in my mouth. His prayer shall continue. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
'Cause you're worthy.
I count it a privilege and an honor to be able to give God praise.
Amen.
Amen. And count it a blessing for everything that he does for me after I'm done giving him praise.
Yes,
the Bible said God inhabits the praises of his people. Isn't it good to be in the presence of God? Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, we're coming to time for our offering. Listen, don't stop giving God praise. Praise and worship is still part of our giving. Offering ties right in with it.
That's
amen.
Right. That's right.
Amen. We want to bless the pastor of this house, Pastor Llanos, in this offering for allowing us to hold an ordination. There's not too many pastors, not too many people out there who will actually open their doors and be like, have your service here. Have your service here. Have your ordination.
Amen.
We don't have anything to do with your denomination, anything that you're doing, but have your service at our church.
That's it.
The Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
The Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Y'all get the best offering that you can. And what I mean, I'm not telling you to, I'm not giving you an amount to give. I'm not giving you an amount to give, but I want God to impress on your heart. What it is, what he would have you give to bless this house.
Yes.
Not Jordan Flows Ministries, not Danuel Cox, not James Taylor, but what we're going to do to bless this house, because it costs money to keep lights on.
Yes.
It costs money for gas, and it costs money for water, and he opened his house freely to us. So we want to be a blessing unto him. Amen.
Amen.
If everybody would please stand. We don't have ushers. We don't need ushers, amen. We don't need ushers. We're going to let the Spirit of the Lord usher us to do what we're supposed to be doing. The offering plate is right up here. And if you would just come and give as you feel the need to give, amen.
Amen.
Continue to praise God. And continue to, listen, people don't have to give, but it's awesome to be able to have to give, amen. Prophetess Rhodes, if you come, I hear it in my spirit to allow you to pray for the offering. Amen. Amen. Y'all don't stop giving God praise.
Yes.
Don't stop. If you need anything, give God praise right now. Listen, you just don't see that God let 100-fold, he will give it back to you. Amen. Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God, we come, God, as humble as we know how, God, with a bowed head and our heart. Yeah. Lord God, I ask you, God, to bless this offering, God, that it may be used for the upbuilding of your kingdom, God. Father God, bless those that gave, God. Bless those that had the desire to give, God, but did not have it, God. Father God, you know their hearts, God. Lord God, you say in your word, if we give, it should be given back to us. Pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Shall men give it to our bosom, God. And Lord God, we take you at your word, God. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Amen. And we want to, Pastor Benny's in the back, so we're going to present the offering to his wife while he's doing ministry. Amen. And Evangelist Alberty.
Praise God.
Praise God.
Praise God.
It's a blessing to be in this house tonight. Amen. You think about all that could have done, went through all day long, but to be in God's house tonight, to worship together, fellowship one another. You know God is well pleased.
Yes, he is.
As we sing, you look around, you might say it's two or no, we praise God for that.
Well, two or three together.
That's it.
That's all it takes.
Yeah, he's in the midst of it.
Glory to God.
Yes, yes, Lord, this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What was this morning? One man once told me, he said, when you wake up in the morning, you put 2 feet on the floor. He said, you start shouting.
I know that's right.
Yes. Yeah. I shout, I wake up.
And your eyes open up.
I just open my eyes and I begin to tell the Lord, I just say, this is the day. I don't care what you have to go through. God, he's faithful. He's faithful to keep us all day long. And so as we come to the time of ministry dance by Evangelist LaWanda,
thank
you, Lord. We just praise God.
Yes,
you come.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah. says. He called out, Lord, I believe. I rely on you.
Yeah, yeah.
I trust you.
Yeah.
I cleave to you.
Yes.
And he worshiped him.
Uh-huh.
We come to worship and bless
yes,
the
we
Lord
do.
On
yeah,
tonight.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes, we do. We come to worship and bless the Lord on tonight.
Amen. 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 Hallelujah.
I call forth an open heaven in this place on tonight.
Yes, yes Lord.
Yes.
So let's connect in the spirit.
Amen.
And let's enter in on together.
Yes.
Let's bombard heaven on tonight.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Let's bombard heaven on tonight.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. So much more. Started in September.
Mm-hmm.
The year of open doors.
Yes.
There are some doors opening in our lives.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And he's ready for his sons and daughters to walk through.
Yes. Yes.
Right.
Walk through praising him.
Yes.
Walk through worshiping the Father.
Yes.
Walk through bowing down before the Father.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
Just the way you are, just the way I bring you. Matheney, and then the best by Pastor Bryce. Boyce, forgive me, Boyce, Pearson.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Awesome worship. Amen. Thank you, Sister LaWanda, for that beautiful day. Jesus, thank you for just bringing the presence even stronger tonight.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. At this time, I would like to introduce to you Pastor Pearson, my holy man of God.
Amen.
Apostle James Taylor, pastors, first ladies, brothers and sisters, and teenagers, children in the Lord, good evening.
Good evening.
It is an honor to stand before you and introduce the guest speaker on tonight, who just happens to be my holy man of God, Pastor Boyce Pearson. He is a tongue-talking, devil-stopping warrior for Christ Jesus.
Amen. Yes, yes.
He speaks the word of God with wisdom, knowledge, understanding. He studies to show himself approved, rightly dividing the word of truth. He prays without ceasing. He humbles himself before the Lord. I thank the Lord for him daily. My husband did 22 years in the United States Army. I watched and learned from him the different hats he had to put on daily. Jesus first, husband second, father third, and the soldier fourth. Then grandchildren came. New hat, papa. At this time, I would like to introduce my husband, Pastor Boyce Pearson. Thank you. It's an honor to be here for such a time as this. Thank you.
Amen.
Awesome worship. Awesome worship. Awesome worship.
Yes,
ma'am. Jesus. Awesome worship.
Before I sing,
normally don't do testimony. I do what I'm told to do. Sing. awesome worship.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Awesome worship.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Several weeks ago, I was asleep, and Pastor Boris and I really I was about to wake up, and obviously the Lord was going to wake me up, but you know I felt myself waking up, and just out of nowhere, if I can get you to close your eyes for a second, I'll show you what happened. I heard this. You are Alpha and Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised. You can open your eyes. And it wasn't anything that I had done. I was subconsciously, you know, I was waking up. And what the Lord showed me, and I won't go into many details as to what he did show me later on. But for that particular, what he did show me was this, is that my inner man desired to worship him.
Yeah, yeah.
My inner man desired to worship him. I subconsciously, I was not there. It was my inner man desiring to worship the Lord.
Amen.
So, you know, that, I thank you for the worship.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. It is up to God. But that's not what I'm going to sing. I belong. So I say, I belong to you, Lord.
I belong to you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
I belong to you.
Amen. Thank you, sir. Thank you, lovely wife. Thank you. Amen. To the bishops. Amen. Bishop. Apostles. Pastors. Brothers and sisters of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I don't take this lightly. Amen. I take this as a privilege and an honor to stand before you, God's people.
Yes, Lord.
God's people.
Jesus.
Amen. It's an honor. It's a privilege. And also it's a great responsibility that we have to stand before you and proclaim the word, the uncompromising word of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
And that's what we want to do tonight. We want to praise God. We want to thank God for what He's doing in the midst of us.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
That's my book.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory to God.
Amen. Hallelujah. So let's get into it. Amen.
Amen.
I am Pastor Boyce Pearson. I just want to, before we start, to thank you, my darling wife. That was awesome. That was very awesome. I almost forgot who she was talking about. She was Amen. She was saying those things. I was like, my goodness, who's that? My goodness. But thank you. Thank you. She is my helpmeet. She's my friend. She's my wife. She's my chingo. She's my partner. Amen. Most of all, she's my woman of God. All right.
Amen. Amen.
She's my good time.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for you. Thank God for you. Amen. Let's get into the word. Amen. If you take the notes tonight, the name of my message is A Gift to Understand.
Amen.
Amen.
And I hope you do take notes, because I believe this is a relevant message to the whole body of Christ. Because in my travels, I spent 22 years in the military, and I traveled the world around. And once I retired after 22 years in the military, God blessed me with a job as a contractor, and I continued my journey around the globe from post to post, from fort to fort, far and wide, from Canada down to Panama, all over the world. And one thing I've seen, one thing in common that we all have, Bishop, is that we all have a hunger and thirst for the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes,
we have all a hunger and thirst to understand Him more and more.
Yes. Yes.
We have a hunger and a thirst, and it's almost to a point where we cannot get satisfied. Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's almost like you got a tapeworm inside of you. That the more you eat, the more you just want more of God. And that's how good He is. But tonight, we're here to, I want us to get a better understanding of what God is trying to do in this time and place. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I don't want to get too far ahead. But the name of this message is A Gift to Understand. Now, in 1 Kings, it's talking about King Solomon is just getting ready to get into his kingly role, his kingly duties, right? And let's just tell you, all right? Let's go to 1 Kings 3. But again, the name of the message is A Gift to Understand. A Gift to Understand. You see, this word understand has a meaning that I believe that we need to understand. I didn't get too many amens.
Amen.
On that.
Amen.
See, we need to understand how to understand.
Amen.
And I'm going to talk about that, but I'm going to show you in Scripture where understanding was a trait of God. It's a trait that we must adapt. It's a trait that we must be able to adapt to ourselves so we can move on in the things of God. Are you tired of where you are in the place of God right now? Do you want to move from where you are?
Yes.
I don't want to be the same old pastor. I don't want to be the same old husband.
Amen.
I don't want to be the same old father. I don't want to be the same old pop. Amen. I want more of God, so I need a better understanding of who God is and my relationship with Him, through Him, from Him.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Now I'm going to show you this in Kings, where King Solomon asked for understanding. Amen. Are you there?
Amen.
Amen.
1 Kings 3, and we're going to butt in on the situation of 6. You said you're there? I'm going to begin to read. And Solomon said, Thou hast showed unto thy servant David, my father, great mercy according as he has walked before thee in truth, in righteousness and in uprightness of heart with thee. And thou hast kept him for this great kindness that thou hast given him a son to sit on his throne as of this day. All right, now I'm going to, for time's sake, I'm going to skip down. Let's skip down to verse 9. Are you with me?
Amen.
So now this is Solomon now, right? He's the king. Now before he takes his office, this is what he's saying. This is what he's going through. Mm-hmm. Amen. So are you there? 9?
Amen.
It says, give therefore thy servant an understanding heart to judge thy people, that I may discern between what? Good and bad. For who is able to judge this thy so great a people? So you see, the great Solomon, King Solomon, he asked God for what? Understanding. So for me, for you to ask God for understanding, that is almost a kingly request.
Amen.
Yes, yes.
It's a kingly request because he's the king of Israel and he's asking his king from a king for understanding.
Come on.
Oh, my Lord.
Amen.
Oh, my Lord.
Yes, sir.
Oh, my God. He's asking for understanding. Let's go ahead on. Hallelujah. And the speech pleased the Lord. See, this is what he asked the Lord. It pleased him what he had asked. So imagine you in your prayer closet, in your rightful place, asking God how pleasing it is for him to hear you say this.
Huh.
My God.
Yes.
My God.
Thank you,
God. My God. A gift to understand.
Yeah.
And the speech pleased the Lord that Solomon had asked this thing. And God said unto him, because thou hast asked this thing, and thou hast not asked for thyself long life, neither has he asked for riches for thyself,
Amen.
Nor has he asked the life of thy enemies,
yes,
but has asked for thyself what? A understanding to discern judgment.
Yeah.
Ooh, Lord
yes,
Jesus.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
He asked for understanding to do the will of God because of this great multitude of people that he was now responsible for. And because he recognized the great responsibility that he has, he knew that he couldn't do it in and of himself.
That's right.
Amen.
So he had to ask because he recognized his what? Weakness. So when I am weak, he makes me
strong.
Come on now.
Amen.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah. Now we are 12. Are you there?
Yes.
Behold, I have done according to thy word. Lo, I have given thee a wise and an understanding heart, so that there was none like thee before thee, neither shall there be any arise like you unto thee. Now watch this, 13. And I have also given thee that which thou hast not asked, both riches and honor,
yes,
so that there shall not be anything among the kings like unto thee all thy days. Because he asked God for a simple thing. He asked him for understanding because God was pleased for what he asked because he only asked for understanding.
He
added to the kitty more riches and honor because now this is why we why we understand why he's in the Bible. With anybody, the Gentiles, the Jews, the Muslims, they all know Solomon as a what?
King.
Not just a king, but a wise king. He was so awesome that the king, that the queen of what?
Sheba.
She had to come and see who this man was. Because she didn't come to see his riches or his gold, apostle. She didn't come to see that.
Yes, sir.
She came to hear the wisdom and understanding that she had of God.
Amen.
Amen.
That's it.
That's
it.
That's it. I'm going somewhere with this.
Yeah, go ahead. Paris.
I'm going somewhere. So I just wanted to wet your whistle. I want you just to know that understanding is a godly thing.
Yeah.
And this is in the Old Testament. Y'all just missed a good place to shut
up.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to God.
Let's fast forward on this, okay? Let's turn to Proverbs. Let's turn to Proverbs 3 and 5. Hallelujah. Somebody say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Proverbs 3 and 5. We're talking about a gift to understand. A gift to understand. We're just talking about understanding right now, because I'm going to take about another 10 minutes and just elaborate on understanding before I get into the gift.
Yes, sir.
It's all right with you?
Yes, sir. All right. Yeah.
All right. Where we at? Proverbs 3 and 5. Are you there?
Amen.
I have to get there. Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
I'm going to go read this, the verse before 4. Thou shalt find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and man. 5. Trust in the Lord with all thy what?
Heart.
Come on now, work with me now. Trust in the Lord with all thy what?
Heart.
And lean not to thy own what?
Understanding.
Wow.
Come on.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
So now we can begin to see what Solomon saw way back in the Old Testament.
Praise God.
Because it's in the New Testament now, right? You see, some things come through the cross, some things stop at the cross. And I'm here to tell you, at the cross of Calvary, understanding went through the cross to you, to me, for us, for now.
Yes, yes.
Amen?
Amen.
It says, do not lean to whose understanding?
Your
own understanding.
Thank you, Lord.
So this implies that I am to have understanding, but whose understanding am I to have?
God.
Now, I'm not saying, don't hear what I'm not saying. I'm not saying don't rely on your own understanding, but it must be influenced by the Word of God.
Yes.
Amen.
Because you know that we are tripart beings, don't you? Don't you know?
Right.
That we have a spirit, and we have a soul, and we have a body. All right?
Yeah, yeah.
Amen?
Come on.
Amen. We have a spirit man, right? Yeah. Our spirit man is the one that who makes contact and communicates with God. Those who worship God must worship him in what? In spirit and in truth. And so it's your spirit that connects and talks to and communicates with God. That's your spirit talking. It's not your mind.
Amen.
The best that your mind can do is have illumination of who God is.
All right.
And what he does.
Come on in. Come on.
Yeah.
So now let's go to our soul. Your soul is what? Your mind, will, and emotions. What is your soul? Your mind, will, and emotions. Your mind. I'm telling you right now, I'm telling you right now, if you cannot understand God with your mind, you cannot get with God spiritually.
Come on here.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I like that.
Some of y'all looking at me like,
amen.
Blasphemy. No, I'm trying to tell you. I'm trying to tell you. If you don't understand God with your own mind, if your own mind, you cannot know that God is the Son, the Father, and the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Because that is a spiritual application.
Amen.
Well, in a spiritual realm, one and one and one equals one.
Hallelujah.
Glory
to God.
Amen. Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Oh, by the way, we three part beings, right? Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Go ahead. Jesus.
You understand what we're saying?
Yes.
So now I'm going to pause. I'm going to take a pause right now. And now let's go into our English vocabulary now.
<Go ahead. laughs>
Understand is made up of two English words, all right? Under and stand. And if you've been coming to my church for a little while, I've been preaching and talking and teaching this to my church, to the people, to the patient, to the church, because we need to get this. It needs to be illuminated to us. Then it needs to become a revelation to us. All right, so now it's understand. Understand made up of two words, right? Under and stand. Under means, look it up in your dictionary when you get home, it means two things. It means to submit and yield to. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen?
I want you to get this, so I want you, I'm begging you to take notes. All right? Because once you take notes and you understand that you get this, it'll propel you to the next level. I don't care where you are in your walk with God.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you. So under means to what? To yield to? And to submit to.
Amen.
To yield, to submit. Stand, S-T-A-N-D, means to, it means a point of view or position. Everybody say a point of view.
Point of view.
Or position.
Or position.
Let that sit a little bit. See that. So when you put the two together, it says this. It says that we are to yield to, submit to God's point of view and position on everything.
Mm. All right.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Hallelujah.
We see in the Old Testament, what did Solomon do? He asked for understanding. He didn't say, "I'll just give me understanding on this little piece of this little part, this part right here, and all the rest I got, God. I got this. I can handle this." Did he say that? No. He said, "Give me understanding," meaning the whole enchilada, the whole pie,
that's right,
on
Hallelujah.
Everything.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
So now, when we read the Bible, when we read his words, especially when it's written in red, because that's Jesus talking, right?
Amen.
Amen. Now, when we read the Bible, so we should come, we should not, what, lean to our understanding, but come on the side where God is, because what, we are tripod beings that come out of our soul and into our spirit, and then what, connect with God spiritually and understand spiritually of what God's trying to tell us in his word.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I know that's simple, it sounds elementary, but we all need to do it. And I bet you, if we tell the truth, and I ask you, we have not been doing that. We all guilty of not doing that.
Mm-hmm.
Because when we go to church, we bring our jobs into the church, and when you hear the pastor tell you this, and you hear the bishop tell you that, or you hear the apostle tell you that, or you hear the evangelist tell you this, or you hear the teacher tell you that, you say, "Oh no, who do you think you are?" Huh?
Hallelujah.
But I'm here to tell you who it is. He is a different God.
Yes.
That's
it.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And that's what we need to understand. That in the fivefold ministry, in Ephesians 4:11, it says, "I gave you some." Let's just go there.
Come on.
I'm ahead of myself, but it's okay, right? It's okay.
Amen.
I don't want to stand to you long, so Brother Sebastian Chambers, check me on my time, please. So we are for Ephesians 4 and 11. Thank you, babe. 4 and 11. Now, again, I'm going to butt into the situation, into the scripture here, for time's sake, right? But I want to encourage you to take this home and read it from start to finish of 4, amen?
Amen.
Thank you, sir. All right, let's start out to with 4 and 7. Are you there?
Amen.
But unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the
gift
of Christ. Okay, so now we went to understanding. We understand what understand means, and we understand how we're supposed to understand.
Right.
We're not supposed to understand or lean not to your own understanding.
Right, right, right.
All right, so now that we got that point across, so nobody in here right now of this as 5 seconds ago should be leaning to your own understanding.
Amen. Amen. That's right.
Amen.
You're on it.
Amen.
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 You're on it.
Okay. All right. All right. Because sometimes I'm telling you, to get into the spirit sometimes is hard.
Yeah, that's right.
It's hard because my soul and my body don't want to do it.
Oh yes, Lord.
Don't tell me what to do. Who do you think you are? I've been doing it like this for the past 61 years. And you want to come tell me what to do? You just got born the other day. Talking about being born again.
Yeah.
Are y'all with me?
Amen.
Okay, 7. But unto every one of us is given a grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Wherefore he saith, when he ascended up high, he led what captivity captive, and did what? And gave gifts unto men. Now listen here, with your spiritual ears. Now that he what ascended, what is it but he, but that he also descended first to the lower parts of the earth. Now watch this. He that descended is the same also that what ascended up far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. Say that he might fill all things. So that means he didn't leave nothing in between. He went up high. He went up low. And that means that he covered everything in between.
Yeah.
He covered everything in between. He said he filled everything. He went up, ascended, and up. Descended, and he covered everything in between. He didn't leave nothing out. He didn't leave nothing out.
Jesus.
He covered it all.
Yeah, that's right.
Lord Jesus.
Anyway, Lord.
Now watch this. If you don't hear anything else tonight, please hear this. For those who have ears to hear, let them hear what thus the Lord is saying to you now.
Amen.
And 11. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors, and some teachers. For what? What did he do it for? I'm glad you asked. For the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. Now watch this. Why and then what? Till what? Till we all come into the unity of faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a what? Perfect man, unto the measure of the status, the fullness of Christ. So I want you to see here, so the name of this is what? The gift to understand. We need to understand that in this chapter right here, in 4 and 11, and God gave us what? Some gifts. And what was the gifts? What? The apostles, the prophet.
Amen.
The evangelist,
yes,
the pastor, and the teacher. For what? For the perfecting of you and me. So tonight, this evening, is a paramount.
Yes.
It's a very important, because tonight you are given, you are here in the flesh. You are seeing God's gift being presented to you. So to you, ma'am. Because in your Bible, unless you ripped it out, it just said, and he gave some. Are you some?
Amen.
Are you some?
Amen.
Are you some?
Amen.
So tonight he's giving some of us a what? An apostle. You were just favored by God.
Yes.
Now you're looking at me, and now let's talk about a gift now, right? We understand this, right?
Amen.
We see this, right? So now watch this.
Hallelujah.
Now we hear the term of being charismatic or charisma. And we know that Christians use the term charisma. And we use it, we use that term kind of loosely. Right? But what do it really mean? Charisma, what do it really mean? Well, in the Greek, it means gift of God. Charisma. It means this. I'm going to read it to you so I make sure I get it right.
Hallelujah.
It's he or she being blessed with a charismatic, highly gift. When Paul speaks of the gift of the Spirit, the Greek word is charisma, which means a gift from God, or a favor of God.
Hallelujah.
It's a gift of God, or a what? A favor of God. So God is giving. Isn't it so appropriate that this is happening right now for tis the season to be
jolly?
Why are we jolly, right? Because God is giving unto us. For God has given unto us a Savior. His name is Jesus Christ.
Yes, sir.
John 3:16, we all know it. For God so loved the world that he what? Gave. He gave his only begotten Son.
Thank you, Lord.
And guess what? And he's still giving now.
Amen.
And he's still giving now. You're here tonight. God has given us a gift. An apostle.
Yes. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise God. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. When Paul speaks of a gift of the Spirit, the Greek word is charisma.
Thank
all right?
you, Lord.
The word is used in reference to the Holy Spirit. So now we know it's God, right? Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. So when I say Holy Ghost, I'm talking about Jesus. When I say Jesus, I'm talking about God. They're all three entwined, right? They just have the personality. My wife, when she got up and introduced me, she said there was different hats that I learned to operate. Well, this is the same ghost truth and with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
So we all understand that. Some of us, we say Father God or Abba Father, we want to come to him as what? As children of God.
Mm-hmm.
Right? As Father, the seed, the provider. Amen. Then when we come to Jesus and say, he's our what? Lord and Savior. He saved me
thank
from myself.
You, Lord.
Yes. Amen.
He saved us from all our sins, right?
Yes.
And then when we say the Holy Ghost, he's the standby. Somebody
come
who comes alongside of you.
Yes.
He's your advocate. The one who comes
yes.
alongside you and helps you. He
yes.
what? He counsels you. He
yes.
leads you. He tells you when to make it right when you go wrong.
Yes.
So what he's doing, he knows when you need a gift. So God is telling us right now, we need a gift.
That's it.
Yes.
Amen.
Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God.
Yes. Hallelujah. The word is used in reference to the Holy Spirit, simply meaning God loving a human being.
Mm-hmm.
It simply means God's loving a human being. Hallelujah. It's God believing in that human being by imparting to him a gift from of the Holy Ghost.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Imparting a gift from him, Jesus. Imparting unto him a gift from Abba Father.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Jesus.
Praise God.
A gift that he has not earned.
No.
A gift which he cannot buy.
Yes,
a gift which cannot be given because of his merit.
Yes.
It's given by the grace of God. God's unmerited favor. Just like when God graced you, he put his grace on you. Why did he grace you? Because of his unmerited favor upon your life.
Yes, sir.
You didn't do anything to earn it, sir, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
He gave it to you. Why? Because he simply loves you. Sisters, you bless me. When you got up and you was talking to him, you said, God loves you. I know that's right. Because
yes,
she yes. cannot say that unless she's under the unction of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
So there's something that we say in our church, Bishop. We say this. We say, I love God.
I love myself.
And I love everybody else.
Amen.
Amen.
You see the priority?
Yes.
You see the position? I love God. I love myself. And I love everybody else. It has to be that way, yo.
Yes.
Because if I don't receive his love, I can't receive the gift.
Yes.
That's it.
You can't receive the gift
That's
if you don't receive the Father. You don't receive the gift. If you don't receive the Son, you can't receive the gift.
Jesus.
If you can't receive the Holy Ghost, you can't receive the
Hallelujah.
Gift.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It's simple, but it's true.
Amen.
I don't get anything. Y'all get anything.
Amen.
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 It's God smiling upon that person so that in turn that person can smile upon the world.
Yes.
That gift is not for him only.
That's right.
God didn't look at him and say, hey, oh man, I like the way you walk. I like the way you talk. God has no respect of person.
That's it. Amen. Say that.
He spent time with God on his knees, on his face, studying to show himself. A workman that need not be ashamed. Rightly divining the word of truth. And then he asked nothing for himself. I met this man 3 days ago, and I know he hasn't asked God for nothing for himself.
Yes, amen.
Thank you, Lord.
I just seen it in his temperament, in his character, in his personality.
Thank you.
You're awful quiet.
Thank
Hallelujah.
You.
It's God, man. God smiled upon that person, so in turn, that person can smile upon the world. The gift works through him, but he can never take personal credit for it.
That's right.
That's it.
That's right.
Because there's nothing that he earned, there's nothing that he did that he could do what? Take credit for receiving.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
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 Another example, this is back in the Old Testament again, is a gift. God gives us gifts. In Judges 6, 1 through 39, it's talking about Samson, the judge of Israel. He was gifted charismatically with the gift of enormous, tremendous strength. Come on,
Amen.
Man.
Amen.
Come
That's
on,
it.
Sir.
Amen.
That was a gift that God bestowed on him.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord.
Let's fast forward up to where we are now. Benny Hinn. How many of us know Benny Hinn?
Amen.
That's a gift of God. He has a gift from God to heal.
Yes.
It's nothing that because he's so great than anything that he did, where he combed his hair, or where he talking, nothing like that. But he spent his time with God
Amen.
Also.
Amen.
You and I, we could do the exact same thing. But all we have to do is get an understanding that God is in the business of gifting us.
Yes.
Lord, hallelujah.
He's in the business of gifting us. He gave some apostles. He gave some prophets. He gave some evangelists. He gave some pastors. He gave some teachers. For what? The perfecting of the saints. So that we may do the work of the ministry. Whoa, that sound funny, didn't it?
Say it again.
That sound indifferent. So that who? Hey, Pastor, I thought you were supposed to do all the work. Wait a minute, Pastor. I thought the bishops, the apostles, the evangelists, the teachers, I thought you were supposed to do all the work. But let's read that. Is it in your Bible?
Mm-hmm.
Paul, let's go back there again. I want to make sure you get this too. Come on, let's read it again. Let's read it. Till we all come, let's read 13. Till we all come into the unity of faith. Of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a what? Perfect man, unto the measure of the status of the fullness of Christ. Let's go back up to 12. 12, for the what? Perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. So what the saints? How many saints we have in here?
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Everybody raise their hand. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many of y'all been out working
Amen.
For the ministry?
Amen.
Amen. That's amen. Amen. For the perfecting. That word perfecting is not a place of being faultless. It's saying that being mature.
Amen. That's it.
It's being mature. We can never reach a place or a point in our lives where we're perfect, where we do nothing or anything, where we can't do no wrong. It means that we go in some place. And maturing, we going somewhere. And notice I said ing. Ing always takes you somewhere.
Yeah.
If you start ing, if you start inging, something that you need to check yourself. Amen. We should always be inging. We should always be working. We should always be moving. We should always be teaching. We should always be learning.
Yeah.
We always should be.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. I'm going to read it in the Amplified. May I?
Yeah.
May I? In 11 in the Amplified it says, and his gifts were varied. He himself appointed and gave men to us. He appointed and gave men unto us. That didn't say me or you. That means all of us. All of yous. Some to be apostles, special messengers. Some prophets, inspired preachers and expounders. Some evangelists, preachers of the gospel. Traveling missionaries. Some pastors, shepherds of his flock and teachers. His intention, what was his intention? I'm glad you asked. His intention was the perfecting and the what? Full equipping of the saints, his consecrated people. Did you know you was consecrated?
Amen.
That they should what? Do the work of ministering toward building up Christ's body, the church. The church.
Amen.
The church. The church.
Yes.
So, the gift of God, the fivefold, the fivefold ministry, is a gift from God. It's a favor of God, Amen. Given unto us.
Amen.
So we can be perfected by what he hears from the Lord God Almighty. So now watch this. When he speaks, we're not to lean to our understanding, because he doesn't, because the pastor doesn't fit the way I think he should look. Or the teacher doesn't speak like I think he should speak. Or the evangelist don't dress like I think he should dress. Or watch this one. Or I don't think he should be preaching to those white folks. I don't think he should be preaching to those black folk. I don't think he should be speaking to those Hispanic folk. Because you think like that because you're in your what? Own
understanding.
Your own understanding.
Hallelujah.
Lean not to your own understanding. I'm going to tell you a story. Can I tell you a story? I'm going to tell you a story. My wife and I, we were stationed in Hanau, Germany. Hanau? At Schaffenberg, around in that area, excuse me. That we was in that area. And we were blessed. We was in the area of Rivers Barracks. Anybody in the military understand Rivers Barracks? So when we was there, they was closing down Rivers Barracks. Mm-hmm. They closed it down. When I say close it down, they took all the Americans out and they gave it back over to the Germans. The German government used it as a refugee camp. Yeah. Yeah. And inside this place, they still had the barracks in there, but each building housed different ethnic groups.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right? Me and my wife and the brothers and sisters in the church that we were at, then we had the opportunity to go inside to minister to the different types of folk. We had the opportunity to go in there to minister to the Sri Lankans. We had the opportunity to go in there and minister to some Africans from Uganda. Right? What blessed us so much was they spoke in their ethnic language. We spoke in our ethnic language.
Yes.
And what I was saying, what we were saying, got over to them, and we was laid out in the spirit.
Yeah. Yeah.
They understood what we were saying. Yeah. Now, I wasn't speaking in tongues, so then did we speak in tongues?
No.
We didn't speak in tongues, so then there need not be any interpretation for them to fall out. We were just talking like I'm talking to you now. And they were saying, hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
That's right, sis. But I'm trying to show you it's a gift. When the gift of God is on you, when God presents himself, no matter what your ethnicity is, if he got something to say to you, he's going to...
Amen.
He's going to get it across.
Yeah.
He's going to get it across.
Right.
He's going to get it across. He used a donkey, didn't he?
That's true.
Amen.
So what I'm trying to tell you that the apostles hasn't died. The apostles didn't go away in the Old Testament. We just don't have the understanding. The church, the body of Christ, didn't have the understanding of God to receive and accept. Oh, I said a word I need to talk about. Receive. Receive. We must be able to receive the gift.
Amen.
To receive the gift. To receive the gift. To receive the gift. Come, can you help me out, sir? No, the brother was sitting right next to you. The blue shirt, can you help me?
Please.
Can I give you something? Is this all right for me to give him? I'm going to give you something. This is for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you. Have a seat. Thank you. So what did I just do?
Yeah.
I gave him a gift. What did he do?
Receive it.
What did he do?
Receive it.
You cannot get a gift unless you
receive it.
Come on now.
Yeah. If you don't understand the things of God, when God's trying to give you something, if you're sitting there trying to understand it, you say, well, I don't need it, God. Well, I don't need that. I don't need this. I don't need no temperance. I don't need no forgiveness. I don't need none of that. I don't need a word of wisdom. I don't need a word of knowledge. I don't need. I don't need. I don't need. But he's trying to give you something that you need. But you, what I, we just don't want to what?
Receive it.
That's good.
So we can read all the stuff that you want to read in the Bible. You can study as much as you want to read the Bible. You can do all this studying and reading and prophesying and do all that stuff that you come up there and show that, and show that, yeah, I just came from Bible study this morning. I just came from prayer this morning. I just came from. But if you don't receive the things of God, you can't get it.
That's right.
That's it.
If that hand clap for me, if that hand clap was for me, that would have been all right. But hand clap for Jesus Christ. You see, we have to be able to receive what God has for us. Understanding, we don't lean to our own understanding. We lean to his understanding.
That's right.
We understand that I'm supposed to receive the gift of God, and I understand that it's from God to me, for me, for my good. For my good.
Amen.
For my good. So I'm not trying to lean to any other understanding. The Bishop Cox over here said God told him to what? Ordain this man as an apostle.
Yes.
God called this man to be a gift unto you, a gift unto me. Now guess what? I don't know about you. I'm ready to receive the gift.
Amen.
Now watch this. I thank God that he thinks so much about me that he's given me a gift.
Yes.
I thank God that he's given me a gift. It's not even Christmas. It's not even Christmas. Christmas is what? On the 25th. God has blessed me with a gift now. God's favoring me now, Bishop.
Yes.
He's favoring me now. He's favoring you. He's giving you a gift.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
So tonight, in closing, in tonight, I ask you to lean not to your own understanding. Put the mind of Christ on. Do not mentally ascend to no place. You just move yourself out the way on purpose. And let God come in and be filled with his understanding.
Yes.
Understand that this apostle is a gift from God. Mm-hmm. Is God favoring you? Mm-hmm. Amen. He's just favoring us tonight. Some of us with a gift. A favor from God.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Would y'all receive him?
Yes.
Would y'all receive him?
Amen.
Would y'all receive him for real?
Yes.
Not just not in word, but in deed.
Yes.
Not just in mind, but in heart.
Yes.
Not then in soul, but in spirit.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Receive him. Receive him.
Thank
receive
you.
Him. Let's stand to your feet, please. And let's give God a hand clap.
Yes, thank you.
Anybody ready to receive?
Amen.
Anybody ready to receive?
Amen.
You know, if we're ready to receive, we have to be in position to receive.
Yes, Lord.
We have to be in the place that we're supposed to be to be able to receive. Now, we've gone through a lot of things just in this week. Me, myself, personally, I keep a smile on my face. Nobody never knows. I'm saying that's how I feel like it should be. Nobody should never know but me and God. But sometimes, you know, I'm glad that we have the church to come to. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. It's altar call time. I said, you know, when we get to altar call time, everybody gets so holy that they don't need nothing no more. But I know that I need you.
Yes.
And we're going to do this out of the ordinary, if you don't mind. Even if you do mind, we're going to do it out of the ordinary. But we're going to ask everybody just to pray. I don't want anybody to come up to the altar unless God is leading you to come to the altar. But God said we should bow down and pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
God's about to change some things and fix some things in the atmosphere right now, even for us at home. God's sending angels right now. And this is the situation that we've been praying for this week. Amen. For our family. Right now, he's sending them. And God's just asking that we bow down. If you don't mind, even if you do, like I said, we're going to give God 120 seconds. That's 2 minutes. God said 2 minutes, and we're going to bow down and pray. If you can, we can bow with
me. Yes,
amen.
Amen.
Thank
you.
Can Brother Tyrone?
Amen.
Can you do a round of I belong to you?
Amen.
Can we do it?
Yes.
Pastor, can we do that?
And if I could have Prophetess, please.
Thank you, God. us.
Thank you, God. My healing right now, God.
I belong to you.
Thank you, God.
My eyes are young.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Be great.
Myself to you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
My life is not my own now.
Healing's in the atmosphere. And by his stripes, you're right. Another gift that he just wants you to receive it right now. I said, the faith the size of a mustard seed can move a mountain. Even less faith than that will heal you. Outside of your body. And I said, even less inside of your body. By Jesus' stripes, you are healed right now. Pastor, by Jesus' stripes, you're healed right now. Pastor Davis, by Jesus' stripes, you are healed right now. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. You don't have to get up if God don't want you up. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Somebody's finances has just been broken to by Jesus. Shifting. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes. We are at a place right now where we're receiving. But along with receiving, we have to believe.
Yes.
Just believe and receive. Receive and believe. Where and how you believe with your heart. You believe in your heart, you receive with your heart.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
It goes back to the beginning. To the beginning of your life with Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
He said, believe in your heart and confess with your mouth. So believe, it starts with your heart. Believe and receive what God is doing here tonight in your heart. In your spiritual heart, your spirit heart. Amen?
Amen. Amen. Listen, Paul and Silas was locked up in an inner cell.
Yeah.
I think a lot of times people need music to pump and prime them to get them to that place, to give God praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
I realize that praise, brother spoke about it when he was talking about waking up. It was his inner man that began to praise God. So I realized that praise and worship cannot just be a time that we have during service, a little musical part. It can also be a lifestyle.
Amen. That's it. That's it.
Listen, I realized this. Paul and Silas showed us. We can look in Acts and find this. That while they were locked up at midnight, they began to praise God. Listen, there was no clapping of the hands. Why? Because their hands was like this on the wall. There was no stumping of feet. Why? Because their chain, they had shackles on their
shackles.
But they began to give God praise.
Hallelujah.
So God allowed me to see. He illuminated this to me, and I got a revelation that it had to have been something inside.
Yes, yes.
Where's your inside praise?
Come on. Mm. Come on.
is something that's inside of you that'll break every chain.
Yes.
Listen, it's something inside of you that will open every cell door, all those things that people have shut on you. God said, I can open them with the praise that I already have placed inside of you. Why? Because it is me that lives inside of you. Listen, the most exciting part about this, and I get excited every time I see somebody praise God, because I realize this from Paul and Silas, that not only did their chains fall and their shackles break and their cell doors open, but everybody around them.
Somebody should get excited.
I love the way the pastor said it. If you get to know who God is, listen, I have a short story before we go on. Y'all ready? It's in the Bible. We're going to go on Peter. You know Peter who walked close to Jesus. Y'all know Peter. You know Peter. Peter who was Jesus' friend. You know Peter. The same Peter who walked out on the water. And then he started to fall because of a lack of faith. You know, Jesus' friend, Peter. You know, the same Peter that was violent, who when the guards and centurions came to get Jesus, he tried to cut off his ear and Jesus had to rebuke him. The same Peter who said, no, they can't come to you, and Jesus had to rebuke him. You know, Peter, Jesus' friend. Peter who also denied Jesus. You know, we all know the Peter that I'm talking about. See, I've realized that there's some Peters. There's some Peters in us sometimes. Because Jesus said to Peter, you're going to deny me. Peter said, no. You know, we sometimes deny Jesus by not doing what we are supposed to be doing. When God says thus, we deny doing thus, says the Lord. Y'all cannot agree, but I know that I'm right. Now, the same Peter denied Jesus 3 times in the cock crowed, and then Peter went to fishing. Let's say Peter went fishing. Peter was no longer with the disciples. Now, Peter, before this, Peter decided, Jesus said, who do men say that I am? Who did men say that Jesus was? Somebody. Who did men say that Jesus was? He said all kinds of stuff. Now, he said, now who do you say that I am? Now, this came to Jesus that there wasn't anything of flesh that gave you who I am. So we understand that Peter was of the Spirit. He had some issues, but he was of the Spirit. You have to recognize who Jesus is before you could ever recognize who you are.
Amen.
I'm getting excited. Listen, I know the punchline. I'm getting excited. Listen, so now Peter left. He went fishing. He denied Jesus. Jesus hung, bled, died, crucified, went to hell, won against the devil, came back, and Mary was there, and he said, Mary, go get my disciples and Peter. Go get my disciples and Peter. I've realized that he had to say my disciples and Peter, not because Peter was no longer a disciple anymore, but because he fell and did not recognize himself to be who he was supposed to be. See, I realized that the gifts and talents and callings of God are without repentance.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Listen, God's called some people to do some things, and we've denied it, and we don't think that we're worthy enough to do those things. But God is calling Mary to tell you to go get you to come back to where you're supposed to be.
Amen.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Listen, some of us have been running and running and running and running and running and running from what God has called us to do, who God has called us to be. God is sending Mary to go get disciples and people. And I had to ask myself, well, why did you tell Mary the disciples and Peter, if Peter was already then a disciple, because if you don't recognize who you are, nobody else will either.
Amen.
So Mary, go get my disciples and Peter, not because Peter's not a disciple, but because you won't recognize him because he don't recognize him. Mm-hmm. But I recognize my child. Yes. God said, I recognize you. I recognize you. This is for somebody. I recognize you. I know who you are. I know what I have called you to be. I know who I have called you to be. Prophetess, I put evangelist on the program, and I apologize. I know what God has called you to be. Evangelist, I'm sorry because I put minister. Okay. No, it's not. It's not okay. That's why I have to correct myself. Listen, God has called people to be certain things. And I'd be wrong if I didn't recognize who you already recognize yourselves to be.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody get excited with me. Yeah, yeah. 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 We're going to enter into our ordination service. Amen. Amen. Everybody may be seated. I do apologize. Everybody may stand. Because we're doing time and says, y'all are being obedient, so y'all gonna be blessed. Amen. We're gonna ask for a prophetess, Joe Peters, to come.
Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, we bless you today, God. Huh? Glory to your name, Jesus. You're so worthy.
Yes,
you're worthy, worthy, worthy. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. Glory to your name, God. You're so worthy to be praised.
Yes.
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 Jesus, Jesus. Mororosha Narekiste. Sina Nana Moshi Kiahose. So Mama Moshi Kiate. Sina Nana Moshi Kiahose. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Yeshenda Ramasa. Miko Roche Kataloboko. Diando Shikiaro. Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. Bless your name, God. Bless your name, Jesus. Hashoma Mama Masatake. Ah, Shinioso Niasi. Nele Shikoro Roshaya. Marelese Roro Shikiara. Midianiasi. Sena Naboko Rosheke. Yes. We bless your name, God. We bless your name, Jesus. Lord, we thank you in this place. Lord, we worship you. God, we reverence you. God, we honor you and we adore you, God. And we worship your holy name, Jesus. We worship your holy name, God. I hear the scripture saying, and at midnight. I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying, what is your midnight? What is your midnight? That your praise will deliver you from. What is your midnight? Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. We need a worship in this place.
Hallelujah.
We need a worship
Hallelujah.
In this place.
Hallelujah.
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 Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus,
Jesus,
Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Most gracious and eternal God, in the name of Jesus. God, we come to you right now, God, as humble as we know how. Lord, we thank you right now, God, for this joyous occasion. Lord, we thank you, God, that you chose us at this time, God. In this season, God, to bless us, oh God, with one that you call your own, God. Lord, and even now, we receive your gift to the body. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you right now, God, for the leader that he will be in your name. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you right now, God, for the example, God, that he will be, God, of your word. The example that he'll be of your will, God. The example that he'll be of your way, God. Lord, we thank you, God, that the spirit that is in him, God, is the very spirit that you gave, the spirit that is in you, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you right now, God, amen, that the candidate, God, that he'll walk as you walk, God, and he'll talk as you talk, he'll speak as you speak, God, he'll hear as you hear, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you, God, that you chose us, God. Lord, we thank you, God, that your spirit is present with us even now. Ah, she, na, 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 oh, she. Ah, God, we thank you. Ah, we thank you, God. We say, have your way right now, God. In the midst of us, God, have your way, God. Ah, Lord, we thank you, God, that we came for a ceremony and ran into a Christ, God. Ah, Lord, we thank you that we came into a service, God, and ran into a Savior. Ah, Rababa Shanda.
Yes,
Lord. Ah, my God, my God, my God. Ah, Lord, we thank you that you're here with us, God. And we receive even now by the power and the authority of the Holy Ghost your gift to the body of Christ, God. And Lord, we say, bless the man of God. Lord, we thank you, God, for your spirit that will engulf him, God, from the crown of his head, Lord God, to the sole of his feet. And I say the commandment that I hear in my spirit commanding concerning the man of God. I hear one word and I hear the spirit of the Lord saying, go. I hear the spirit of the Lord saying, go, man of God. In Jesus' name we pray, God, and we thank you for all that you've done, God, what you're doing right now, God, and the things that you are going to do. We give you glory. We give you honor, God, and we give you praise. And it's in your son's matchless name that we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Do we have any ordained ministers in the audience? The ordained ministers, if you would come to the pulpit. Pastor Benny. We're going to ask Apostle James, James Taylor, to come down to the podium. Before you, Pastor James Taylor. We will give him his charge. Charge of an apostle. Jesus. Apostle Taylor, will you accept this call and fulfill this trust in obedience to Christ?
I will.
Will you be faithful in prayer in this study of the Holy Scriptures? And may you have the mind of Christ.
I will.
will you boldly proclaim and interpret the gospel of Christ, enlightening the minds and stirring up the spirit of the people?
I will.
Will you encourage and support all people in their gifts in the ministry and nourish them with God's holy grace and prayer without ceasing and celebrate them?
I will.
Will you guard the faith, unity, and discipline of the church?
I will.
Will you share? Will you share with your fellow ministers and the government of the whole church? Will you sustain your fellow ministers and take counsel with them? Will you guide and strengthen all who minister in the church?
I will.
Will you be merciful to all, show compassion to the poor and the strangers, and defend those who have no help?
I will.
Amen. Our charge to the body of Christ, also found in your programs if you have your paper. Brothers and sisters, you have heard how great the charge is that James Taylor is ready to undertake. And you have heard his declarations. Is it now your will that he should be ordained?
Amen.
Will you continue to pray for him?
Amen.
We will.
Will you uphold and encourage him in his ministry?
We will.
Amen. We're going to now ask Bishop Wendell Davis to come as we lay hands. Apostle, if you would go before the pulpit, kneel.
Father, we ask you, Lord, Father, as we do the press the tyranny of the laying of hands.
Yes.
Father God, you say in your word, Father God, lay hands on no man but suddenly. And Father God, we show, Father God, favor, Father God, that you have appointed, Father God, and ordained, and called out, Father God, Lord, this servant, Father God, Lord, into the, Father God, the calling of the apostles.
Yes.
And Father God, we lay hand, Father God, and elevate him, Father God, in the rightful calling. And Father God, we ask you, Father God, as you lift him up, Father God. Lord, we ask you, Father God, to ordain him, Father God. Lord, in the walk, Father God, in the walk of an apostle.
Yes, God.
Father God, at the laying of the presbyterian of hands right now. Father God, we decree, Father God, and Father God, from this day forward, Father God, Lord, that you will lift him up, Father God, to edify, Father God.
Yes, God.
Lord, the saints, Father God, Lord, that are under him.
Yes.
Father God, we ask you, Lord, right now, Lord,
yes.
Father God, that you examine him, Lord.
Yes,
and Father God, find that he's worthy, Father God, of that walk.
Yes.
And Father God, as we lay hands and touch and agree with him, Father God, right now. Father God, we share, Father God, the bloodline. Father God, from generation to generation. And Father God, we do, Father God, come in agreement right now. Father God, as a presiding bishop, Father God, I do lift him up right now.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, have your way, God. Have your way, God. Have your way, God.
Right now. Lord, pour into us. Pour into his spirit right now. Lord, his journey may not be easy. But Father God, you said you'll never forsake him, nor leave him. Father God, we ask you right now for your covenant, Father God, as an apostle. Father God, one, Father God, Lord, shall walk alone, Father God, but Father God will walk in your anointing.
Yes,
Father God, one, Father God, Lord, that will set the house in order.
Yes,
Lord, that will call what is wrong right.
Yes.
Father God, that will go against the grain.
Yes.
And Father God, I ask you, Lord, right now, Father God, Lord, that he is the one, Father God, that will point out, Father God,
what can
those things.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Those things, Father God, that is not right, Father God, in thy kingdom. And Father God, I ask right now, Lord, I pray for him, Father God. Lord, I touch and agree with him, our Lord. And Lord, all his brothers and sisters right now. Father God, as we come in agreement, Father God, right now. Father God, our spirit, Father God, cover him. Father God, as he go forth and do the will of God. Lord, we touch and agree as a church body. Father God, one Father, one Spirit. And Lord, we divide right into him right now. We pour into him right now. Lord, we lift him up right now. And Father God, we ask you, Lord, right now, Lord. Lord, the church's spirit, Father God, when he's down. Lift him up, Father God, when he's, Father God, feels down low, Father God. And Lord, we ask you right now, Father God, for your concentration of him, Father God. Lord, in the walk, Father God, as an apostle of Jesus Christ. Lord, we ask you, Father God, and we agree right now. In Jesus' name. Let it be so. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Let it be so.
Hallelujah.
My God.
Thank you, God.
Oh, yes, Lord. The hands of God is on the
throne.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Give God a hand praise.
Yes,
God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And we present to you Apostle James Taylor, if you would stand.
Receive your gift. Amen. 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 Amen.
And we'd like to present. or his certificate of ordination to apostle.
Yes,
we're going to have
some
have remarks. Then we're going to have Bishop Davis have remarks. We're going to have Pastor Pearson have remarks. I'm going to have little remarks. And we're going to ask Pastor Benny to come and have the closing remarks and give the benediction. For this is his house, and we always will respect the man of this house.
Amen.
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 Amen. Let church say amen.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Yes,
Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. I give God the praise and all the honor, amen, because it all goes to God, amen, to his son, Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Amen. God has put me on a journey, trials and tribulations, amen, processing me for this day. I never knew that this would happen, amen, but it's a long story, but my journey ended here in Lawton. Amen, by the grace of God. And I tell you, I've been through so much, but it was for, amen, the process of what God was trying to do for the kingdom of God, not just for me, amen, but for his people, amen, that need to hear the word of God, amen, because God get all the glory.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
I thank God, amen, for Pastor Benin, amen, letting us come here tonight, amen, and amen, for Bishop Wendell, amen, to Boyce Pearson, Pastor Boyce Pearson, that spoke the word so beautifully, amen, to Bishop Cox, amen, to the prophecies, to Peters, amen, thank you, Jesus, and to my sister-in-law, amen, prophecies, LaWanda Moore, and to my brother, I believe he got a pastor calling on him, amen, in the name of Jesus, but God, amen, he's wonderful, amen, we got to just stand, amen, stand up on God's word,
amen.
Stand up on everything that God said, amen, and whatever God tell you to do, do it by faith.
Yes.
Amen. Because one thing about this walk, you got to have faith in what God tells you to do.
Amen.
Amen. You got to have the first fruit of the Spirit, and that's love. Amen. For one and another. Amen. Love for them that are out there lost in the street. Amen. Drug dealers, crackhead, prostitutes. Amen. Them people out there, they need the word of God.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. And I just want to work with the people here in this town, this city, amen, all over the world, and just do what God say do.
Yes.
And let's bring the lost souls back home.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise God.
Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
First of all, I want to give honor, amen, to, amen, Pastor Benny for allowing us to be here.
Amen.
And to his wonderful wife, amen. And to Bishop, amen, Cox, amen, for actually inviting us to be here, amen, to this anointed, amen, occasion, amen. And to all of the leaders, I'm not going to call names. Amen. Get in trouble by calling names. Amen. But all of the apostles, amen. All of the, amen, evangelists, all of the teachers, all of the preachers, amen. All of the five-fourth ministry gift, amen. And all of the bishops, amen, that are here. And I don't want to leave my wonderful wife out.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I want to thank God for her. Amen. And to my armor bearer tonight. Amen. To all of you, amen. I want to just say a remark to, amen, to Apostle Taylor, amen. I felt such a great anointing that's on him, amen. I've been doing this only just for a few years, since 1974, just a few years, amen. Amen. That's only, it's not even a day yet,
amen.
Just for a few years. Amen, and truly I want to say to you, amen, because, amen, it's about what God does for you tonight, amen, and I enjoyed the message, amen, I love the message, if they heard what you spoke tonight, if it just went in the ear, and hit their spiritual ear, and stayed in their heart, praise the Lord, if it was a message, amen, it was good food.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. I had the opportunity when I was in Italy, amen, we had a custom where we fold the napkin.
Wow.
Amen. Saying that the meal was good.
Amen.
Amen. So we'll fold the napkin,
amen,
and that's because the food is good tonight.
Amen.
Amen. Because there was a word, amen, for the occasion. Amen. We want to thank you, amen, for being the hostess at this dinner. you, amen, as an apostle, amen. I just want to say to you, just right here, keep it pure.
Amen.
Keep it pure. Amen. One of the key things, amen, that you will have to walk sometimes, amen, in the dark. But one thing about it, amen, Jesus will always be with you. Amen. Keep your sword always sharp.
Amen.
You're not going to be light. Amen. Remember that. If you remember that, you're not in for a popularity contest, that you're in here for a savior. Amen. And that one of the key things is that you're going to make some enemies on the way. Amen. But you're also going to pull some people out of the lion's mouth.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Yeah, remember that not all is going to be going your way. Amen. But save as many as you can.
Yes.
Amen. And as apostle, remember this right here. Tell the truth.
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to just say this right here. Praise the Lord. A lot of people don't like apostles. I'm just going to help you out. Amen. Because apostles will come in your church and mess your church up. And you're the one who could hit you. Because they're coming in and they call some things out and sometimes they start with the pulpit. And then they work to the congregation and then you're like, I don't want that apostle to come back no more. Amen. I'm going to sit down. I had words. Amen. But I just want to let you know. Amen. You're going to have some shipwrecks. Amen. But guess what? You won't lose none, praise God, because guess what? The Lord's going to be with you.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
You're going to do some shaking. Remember, the Lord's going to be with you. Amen. And remember this right here. Always remember that God said he'll never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. Remember that. Remember what your purpose is. Amen. Purpose driven. Amen. And I thank God for all of you. Amen. So I'm going to pass the baton on. Amen. To the next person.
Glory to God.
Yes.
You guys been happy to see me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I just want to say that it was, again, a privilege and an honor to stand before you, brothers and sisters of the Lord, the saints of God, and deliver the word of God to you as best that I can deliver it from him. Amen. I would like to just leave you with this, that Jesus, God, Jesus, the Holy Ghost, if you're likened to a football team, all right, God is a quarterback. God is a quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing about being on on the team is we all got to study the same playbook.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
We all got to study the same playbook, those 66 books in the Bible, amen?
Yes.
All right? So as you line up, on Team God, just realize and understand your position. Because the playbook lets you know your position. Amen? But one thing about a wide receiver, the wide receiver knows where the ball's going to be.
Amen?
Amen? The quarterback throws the ball to the spot. So just like Bishop was saying, He positions himself to receive. Amen. So likewise, I want to leave you guys with this word. Position yourself to receive on purpose what God have you to understand about him and yourself. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen. I'm excited, y'all.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I'm so honored, not only just to be in the presence of God, but to be in the presence of you all and all of them, and all these wonderful men and women of God in this place. I was getting things together, and a lot of people didn't realize I was ordained a bishop. October 17th, 2003. This is my fourth ordination that God said to go forth in. And I was just doing what God said, just listening to what God said. And I was like, okay, God, well, we're a community organization, so we have to do this right. We're not a church. We are ordaining people so they can go forth in their ministries. Because, you know, men, they have this issue about if you don't have these papers, you're going to get in trouble. So I did what thus says the Lord. I went to apostle. I said, God told me to ordain that I'm going to ordain you. And witnessed with both of us. I just want to thank everybody for coming out and supporting apostle. Man, I do. I'm so honored to be in everybody's presence today. And I just know that I'm blessed because of you. Each and every one of you. And then I want to thank Bishop and Pastor for coming. Listen, you know you have friends when you can call somebody and be like, listen, I need you here. They just say, okay, before they find out what it is. I need you. All right, what you need. I love it. That's favor.
Yes.
Listen, you get favor with God, you'll find favor among men.
Yes. Yeah.
And I love the favor of God. They say favor's not fair. I never thought anything about life was fair, so favor's okay with me.
That's all right.
Amen. And I want to thank God for the prophetesses in the building. We got
Amen.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We brought all the prophetesses out in the building. Amen. And I just want to thank everybody who's on the program. Listen, I've been to a lot of programs. You know, we've been to a lot of programs in our lives. And we look at programs, and a lot of times there's always somebody who didn't show up. Mm-hmm. Anybody want to praise God with me? Because everybody's showing up. Some people got out of our program today and was put on program. Thank you so much, Prophetess.
Yes, sir.
And she's saying beautifully. She said, give her a hand for her. She appreciated an awesome job. I seen her in the morning day. Minister Taylor, she tricked her. She did. Minister Taylor tricked. She said, sing something. I said, all right, well, I have a program tonight that I need you to be on. And she came. Pray, you know, you can't do that to everybody. You have to always have the rams in them. I didn't have to use a ram. In the name of Jesus. Second place is it's all right. But the first place is always, you always know you're a winner when you're first place. Ain't nothing like a gold anything. Amen. And I want to thank God for Prophetess Peters. Awesome woman of God. Awesome woman of God. I say I keep counsel with some wonderful people, if I do say so myself. And I thank God for her. She don't even realize I keep counsel with her. I do. I listen to everything she said. I hear it in the spirit. And Pastor Pearson, thank you so very much. Thank you. Prophetess Pearson, thank you very much. Prophetess Alberty, thank you so very much. Bishop, thank you very much. And then I want to also thank Apostle James Taylor for receiving me.
Yes.
Bishop again for the ministry. That's all I have to say.
Thank you, Jesus.
I try not to be long-winded, but if you know my daddy, I'm long-winded because my spiritual daddy and my natural daddy, Binda and Brother Cox, they both some long-winded people. They long-winded, ain't they? If I got Pastor B to come and give remarks and then close us out. Please stand as the man of God of this house comes.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise God.
The Ordinarios. God is good. Do you have bueno? The vision of God's oración interpreted in English as house of prayer is that we are a bilingual church. We don't limit ourselves because Spanish is our first language. Because we also speak and understand English with an accent that we speak. And so when we get our Caucasian brothers and sisters, our African American brothers and sisters, our Korean brothers and sisters into Casa Oracion, I let them know that they're going to learn the first three words when they enter to those doors. It is the name of the church. Because if the Yoruba bilingual church, so why don't you call it Casa Oración / House of Prayer? Because you want, I want you to feel that you are in the rest of the culture. So you learn to say Casa Oración. And then I tell them, say it with me, Casa de Oración. And some of them get it right the first time, and then some of them, I just got a pamper. Yeah, you got it, brother. Pass out the Oración. Yeah, close it up, brother. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I want to ask the sister, do you work in Eisenhower? Praise God. What a small town, huh? Amen. She's seen me at Eisenhower, and I go visit some of my students over there. God bless you. And I am honored to have you here. Praise God. And she has taught me today what the Lord has said to the servant of God that he passed on to the apostle. Praise the Lord. Stay pure. Keep your testimony an open book. When my wife and I go, because we're not a perfect couple, we love each other, right, Eden? And I'm not going to preach, but I'm long-winded too. I'm not, I know we're going to go home, we're going to go to Sunday school, but, and I'm not going to collect an offering. Praise God. But when the first lady and you're truly go to Walmart, and we're not agreeing on what we're going to eat for dinner, and we start that discussion, and it gets into an argument, and then it dawns on me, Eden, we're in a public forum now. You heard that saying, the world that is?
Yeah.
Because I've had sheeps in my church say, Pastor, man, I went to Walmart, and the pastor and the first lady were going at it. Oh, my God, I didn't know she could talk like that. So praise God. I think I have behavior every time I've gone to Eisenhower, right? Thank you, man. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Walk in the light and stay pure for the Lord. Congratulations. And we are honored. And when the bishop, and I call him Brother Cox because of the relationship that we've developed throughout the years, but I want to honor him with his calling. When Bishop Cox told me what they were planning to do, and he had Casa Oración as the place that he wanted to do this event, I felt more than honored to say yes. This is the first time we have an event like this, and I don't believe only Pastor Taylor got blessed, but I believe Casa Oración got blessed.
Yes, yes.
Thank you all for your beautiful blessing. Yes. And with every respect to the sister that broke her mind, if you don't mind, I'm going to put it on Facebook, okay? Yes. You don't mind me putting it on Facebook? It was beautiful. Praise God. Because I want to let my sheep know with love what you missed tonight.
Yeah.
Okay? We had a feast. Praise the Lord. And look what you missed.
Yes.
And tomorrow I know they'll tell me, if Jesus doesn't come by tomorrow, they'll tell me, praise the Lord, why they couldn't come. Hallelujah. Oh, praise God. But I thank you for each and every one of you. And as we Spanish people say, mi casa es su casa. That means my house is your house. Praise God. I want to honor everyone, and I'm going to say, like Bishop, the Pastor Wendell said, I don't remember all the names. I'm not good. I don't want to leave anybody out. But we're honored by your presence in this place. Pastor Pearson, it was an honor and a pleasure to meet you. And I told Brother Pastor Bethlehem that I got to meet you and talk to you, okay? I'm happy that the Pastor Shure Foundation came here. Praise the Lord. First Lady. We had some good times when they were across the street with neighbors. Praise the Lord. Thank you, everybody. Tomorrow, we're going to have church again. And let's close our eyes now, and I'm honored to close the service. And we are closing this service, Lord. But we have been drawing from your presence. We humbly came into this house of God that we call Casa Oración to ordain, Lord, your son, your servant. And now, Father, as he's set forth to do your will, I ask you to be lap on his to his feet and lead him, Lord. I pray for every soul that came into this house, Lord. in obedience and led by the Spirit. That as we leave this place, God, you will continue to guide us to our destinies, to our homes, Lord. And if it pleases you to see us wake up tomorrow and go to our churches, Lord, that we may continue flowing in this anointing, God.
Yes,
bless every leader in this house, God. I pray for their ministry that you will continue to add on those that are going to be saved, God, to their house. Put a fresh word in our mouths, Lord, for tomorrow's message. And I now, Father God, close this service with your blessing. And I ask you to lead us to our homes in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And God's people say,
amen.
Amen. God bless you, dear children.
God, I'm